Jeg skal finde på en anden undskyld for den sted.
Ja, jo.
Altså, og jeg ved bare, jeg giver magt på mig selv, jeg skal afsted.
Ja.
Og det er min historie.
Well, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. And as you can see, I have Johnny on a visit today. We're going to make an overnighter here. And actually the reason why I invited Johnny is because I have this, you can see here. Yeah, a lot of firewood I have to saw and split. So, that's nice to have a slave in here, a trull as we call it in the Viking Age. So he can help me do that. Yeah, of course, we're going to have a nice cozy evening here and hopefully a wonderful night too. The weather is perfect, there's no wind and it's actually pretty warm out here. I think it's about 15 degrees Celsius, so it's going to be a nice cozy night. They talked about a little bit rain later. I don't know if it's coming or not. And perhaps tomorrow a rain, but the weather forecast is very different depending on where you are watching it, so we'll see. And no matter what, we are going to have a very pleasant time out here. It's good to have Johnny back, and that's the first time I'm using my new Viking house as a shelter for overnighters, and the first time Johnny is watching that, seeing my shelter, so that's cool too. Yeah. We are preparing some very nice food tonight, and of course we have some beer with us and other stuff. So I hope you hang on, and I'm glad you came along. Yeah, and I've saved this log for a while. I'm going to make a log fire tonight, a long fire, and if this is dry enough, it will be perfect for that. See here, starting to split. I can hear it cracking. Whew, hard work. Just a moment. Had some widgets. Almost there. Oh yeah. But it looks a little wet inside, so perhaps I'll make another one with some more dry wood. Yeah. Now I'm going to start my fire, and if there has been sunshine at the moment, I would have used this. Look at this. It's a magnifying glass that I got from a friend in Canada called Steve. It's the Hudson Bay magnifying glass. It's so cool, and it's had leather. It's framed in the leather and a strap around my neck. It's so cool. I'm so grateful for that, and I'm looking forward to using this, Steve, one day when there's sun. So that is the reason why I don't use that today, but I'm looking forward to that. So, and instead of using this, I have another thing I would like to show you.
So hang on.
Yeah, and look at this, a gift I've got from Lemel Coffee. And inside here, there is this awesome set. A ferro rod, a striker, so I can make my fire. Isn't it cool? Lemel Coffee. Yeah, and I haven't used it yet, so it's still a little bit new, but it's giving a good spark. And I'll see if I can light this fire down here. This is birch bark, and yeah, perhaps it will be a good solution to put a little bit fat wood down there. I think so. I just use this fire, this fat wood, make some shavings here. Yeah. I think this is enough. And see here, I think it's curly birch. The handles, so beautiful. There we are. This is just ordinary potatoes I bought, and it's very delicious when you do this. Put a little oil on them. And then I have some spice here. In here I have some spice, Montreal spice. It's steak spice, but it's very good on everything actually. Yeah, and then Miguel from Spain sent me these two. It's paprika, and he knows I love paprika. And he sent me a hot one and a sweet one. And yeah, I'm not that's not fond of hot stuff, but I'll use this a little bit and then more of this. Just take a little bit. I know Johnny is very fond of spicy foods, so he deserves it with all his work on the firewood. Then the sweet one, which I prefer. And this is something special from Spain that Miguel has sent me. Yeah, thank you very much. And now it's going on the fire. Now the potatoes is finished, so we have a lot of food today. We got a spare rib and some medallions that we're going to put on in a moment. But first I'll take this one off. The barbecue sauce. Some Montreal spice on them. I'm not sure Johnny has tasted this. Again from a friendly subscriber.
Oh yeah, looking good. And for the final, some asparagus. It's very nice on fire, on an open fire. A little bit too much open fire now. Now comes the rain, so we have to move fast. I think we have to, well, I think the meat is finished. Cool. Har du den, så tager jeg, hvis du tager den over, så tager jeg asparsen på den der.
Ja, skål. Yeah, and as you probably can hear, it's raining. But it's very cozy out here, and you can sit in the shelter, my little Viking house, and be warm there and dry. But I hope it will be over soon, so I can make my log fire here, and we can sit a little bit outside this evening. It's 8:30 now, and in a couple of hours it's going to be dark. And luckily it stopped raining, so I can make my log fire like this. Bit there. Yeah. It's going to be okay. Now I think it's time for coffee. So we'll let it heat here. And we have a lot of water today because we are two. So I think this is perhaps a 7, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and one more for the road. Yeah, that'll do. And then of course some salt in. For those of you who know, you don't know, it's salt removes the bitterness from the coffee, and especially in cooking coffee you can feel a little bitterness, so the salt helps you remove that. Now it's beginning to boil, and I have to be careful so it not boils over. Regulate the heat here and let it boil for a minute or so. Looking forward to a cup of coffee. It's our first coffee here in the camp today. We had a couple of beers, or three, in the afternoon, so we forgot to drink the coffee. I think this is enough.
The foam is gone from the surface, as I told you before in a previous video. So, yeah, let it rest for a minute.
You're ready. Okay, that's good. Yeah, you want some special liquid in?
Please.
And then, ready? Wink. It's nice to have you around here. Yeah. Enjoying this wonderful evening. You can hear the birds are singing and the fire is crackling. So it's a perfect night. Skål, everyone, and skål, John. Thanks for coming and visit to me and doing all the hard work. This is how it looks on my surveillance camera. It's, yeah, in the night it's totally dark. And we have a little light in here and fire in front. Men så var det alligevel en god aften her til slut, ja? Ja, det var skønt.
Jo.
Johnny and I are sharing some beer and whiskey. Have a good time and soon we'll hit the sack and hopefully get a good night's sleep. Yeah. Good night everyone. See you tomorrow. Both Johnny and I like them crispy, so these are definitely. And this is just 4 eggs and a little bit of a little bit of milk. Finish breakfast.
No. You look happy first.
Ja, hvis du vil have, den ene lidt sat, den er lysest, og det er peber.
Det er
fint, ja. Det er også sat. Thank you.
Yeah, and this is my homemade salt and pepper shaker. In here, there's salt, you see. And then on the other side, I've got pepper in here. So, little thing. I think I made a tutorial about it. I can't remember. Look in my playlists, videos with DIY project in. Maybe you find it there. Yeah, this is all for now, folks. Hope you enjoyed this little video from my overnight together with Johnny here in my new Viking house. It's been a wonderful night, cozy and warm, and there came a little bit of rain during the night. I woke up about 6 and I could hear the rain on the roof. It's very nice to lay in a dry shelter and listen to the rain. Yeah, but in the morning the rain was gone and we could make our breakfast over open fire here, bacon and eggs, very delicious. And yeah, had a good time, cup of coffee and a little pipe, you know. So everything is good. Now we are going to pack our things and I'm heading home to my place, and Johnny lives south in Denmark, so he's driving home there. So, but thank you again for watching Cimbrer Bushcraft. I really appreciate that, and welcome to all my new subscribers. I've gained 70,000 now, and I'm really proud of that. And grateful for all the kindness and support you're giving me. Yeah, thank you very much for that. Hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.